Welcome back to the Ghost Key. I am Gray, and today we have some more Lotro and a lot of fun.
Unfinished shit. Business.
Wow, what the fuck did you just say?
Unfinished business.
Oh, wow. That's what that was. Okay, then. Yeah. yeah. Alright, so we have to return the Karn Doom gate key to Lorneal and then go rescue Goladir. Because.
So we are heading towards Angmar?
Yes, we gotta go to Angmar. So, fun stuff. Fun stuff. And if I remember right, I think we're gonna have one instance to do, but it's gonna be kind of a big instance, I think. And depending on...
I don't think we're going in there yet, are we?
Yes, we are.
Oh.
We're gonna go turn the key into Lorneal, and then we're gonna go straight into that motherfucker. Straight into that shit.
One.
You don't know what we're doing because you've never done this one, so this is all new shit to you. But we are gonna go to Lorneal and do that. It's gonna be fun. I don't know if we're actually gonna be able to complete it. Might be a little. I remember doing it on my Runekeeper, and it was a bitch. It was a bitch. I think
you were also ranged.
True, and I think I failed it once. I'm not sure. I think.
You gotta go Westbury.
Yeah, then I'm gonna travel. Westbury, and then from there to Esteldeen, and then from there should be able to get there. Should.
Alright.
Should. Anyway, that's what we're gonna do, and like I said, I think it's a pretty big one. I remember it being a relatively lengthy instance. A lot of cool shit. But, yeah, so we'll do that, and like I said, the time it'll take us to travel there, and then do all that.
Greetings.
Should be about how long the episode will take. You're probably wondering why in the fuck we're not just skipping all this traveling. It's part of the game, as far as I'm concerned.
Well, at least it shows you how to connect the places. So you know which one you're supposed to use to get there.
And like I said,
Because you can't just fly from one point and...
Yeah, and then just go there.
Take you there.
Yeah. I'm not big on portals and all that shit. I'm just like portal jumping and all that shit to get somewhere. I mean, I'm not going to sit here like... I've got, friends that like fucking map out the quickest way to get to anywhere in World of Warcraft with, the fucking portals. So they'll fucking bind at a location that is, the best place, quote unquote, to fucking get anywhere and... Get everywhere. I'm not. I just don't give a shit.
Stablemaster, pop up. Bill Rosewood. Hello.
You having some troubles? Troubles there? That always does take a while sometimes, though, even for my computer once in a while. Like I said, I think it's more shit on there, and that takes a while for it to get called up. That's still in right there. Right there. There you goes. And then we'll have to ride slowly all the way to Ogier, and then, whatever the hell it's called, Gathforth near, and all that good shit. So, like I said, honestly, traveling, I mean, there are no direct portals. I mean, you have Swift travel, but...
Swift travel's nice.
Yeah, and you can bind to locations and all that stuff.
Well, you also have rally points, too, if you have rally horns.
Yeah.
That just requires one person to be there, though.
Yeah.
Already.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's... Like I said, it's...
So I think there's a rally point outside of each major city.
Is there? I think.
Yeah. I know in, like...
I haven't looked into that at all, honestly. I know...
I've had to use rally horns a few times.
I know, like the rangers... Honestly, if you want someone that's going to travel fast and travel to a lot of different, places very quickly, rangers are the way to go because they have a lot of ports and can bind to several different locations and all that shit. Not only can they port, but they port the whole damn party. Now, wardens can do that, but they only port themselves. And they don't get as many, I don't think, as many port locations. But
Why do you need to go into Garth?
I can't because it's yellowed out, just like it is on yours. Oh. You can't travel there, Swift Travel, can you? Dork.
I was like, wait, I can't if I want to really waste some mithril.
No, Jesus. No, you don't want to waste mithril on that. Save it for your fucking horse.
Horses.
Yes. Anyway, But and like I said, I kind of like the idea of like I like the idea of traveling to a location because it makes it more important to me, as opposed to just port somewhere and complete some mindless task. Eh. But that's just me.
The only time that gets annoying is when I'm just crafting. I'm not really doing something.
Yeah. I guess that's what I'm saying. Is like with a main storied quest line, the actual journey and traveling to that location for me is, you know, is more exciting than, or not really more exciting, but is a part of that quest line as opposed to just porting somewhere just for the sake of grinding and getting a shit ton of wood for your fucking, you know, woodworking skill. Yeah.
Oh, I got a pretty horse.
Yes, anyway. But like I said, I mean, traveling gets a lot easier the higher levels you get in this game for obvious reasons. You get, you know, the various locations are more available to you because you have to have level requirements and sometimes quest requirements. Like you have to have certain deeds completed, and like Eregion is one of the places where you need you need to do some deeds and complete some shit to get swift travel to go there. I'm not gonna do that for some of those places because don't end up questing there all that much. But
sometimes it's just rep.
Some of them, but not all of them. Like I said, a lot of them are D's. Like you do the, you know, do 40 quests or whatever in that zone to get the swift travel there. But yeah, most of those though that you do are for zones that you don't travel to regularly. That makes sense. Like this one, like ones that aren't like. I guess what I'm saying is ones that you just travel through. Yes, yeah, we have to have acquaintance with Council of the North.
Yeah.
Iorland. Fuck. Where the fuck is that?
I'm coming.
No, you're fine. I'll just go swiftly to get whatever the hell.
Eventually, I'll get there.
Yeah, you'll be fine.
Shivas. No, Shiva. No. Love you. Go away.
But you're sitting down and doing nothing. Go away.
No, you're going to sit on my keyboard.
Yes, you will. Or just stand very awkwardly and then decide to run away at a moment's notice. No, nothing. Absolutely nothing. Silence.
She's telling you to screw off.
And she's like, fuck you. Fuck you.
Let me do what I want. I want to stand on your keyboard and make your fucking computer freak out.
Yeah, so we do have to run up there. Yeah, because we don't have the standing with the Council of the North. Shit, I haven't even done anything. That's weird.
I thought we would since we start. I don't know. Yeah. We haven't really done any quests for them.
So. Well, this chapter and shit, and we're going to do more stuff up here in the next chapter, so... I assume we would have had that at least opened up so we can see that shit.
Oh, and also if you get really lazy, there's a little blue dot over there.
Yeah, yeah, you can do that.
It just takes you to the quest.
Yeah. Like I said, I hoard my shit. I hoard that. I save that shit. Because quite honestly, a little bit of time doesn't bother me. Besides, I like this game. I don't mind traveling in it. That makes any sense.
Some people like it.
Like what?
It just depends on what game I'm playing.
Yeah, I can see that.
And WoW, I'm just like constantly going. I don't stop.
You're constantly going, you don't stop. I don't know what that means.
Like, no, I don't stop and look at the environment and anything like that. I'm like, no, I want to fucking get there quick.
Yeah. And the environment isn't anything to write home about.
In this one, it depends on which zone I'm in.
Yeah, some zones are more difficult than others.
No, some are prettier than others, so I don't mind walking.
But that's the thing too about this game is like you don't like just fly through areas like you do in like games like WoW, where you can, you know, spend quest in one zone and be done with that entire expansion. You don't have that in this game.
Well, and also like
In that game,
oh crap! What is it? I just said the game earlier.
I don't know.
Neverwinter. Yes, Neverwinter. I'll travel that all day.
Well, that's instance though, so it really cuts down on a lot of your travel time.
But I still like some of the places.
Oh yeah, no, I'm not saying anything's wrong with that. I'm just saying it's instanced, so it's
Final Fantasy.
Final Fantasy was
gorgeous.
Yeah, Final Fantasy is very pretty, very nice.
Rift was okay. I didn't have a problem. Things were close enough that it didn't seem like you traveled that far.
Yeah, yeah. Rift wasn't bad. Like I said, Rift wasn't terrible to play, but then you get out of, like, that's something too. Like, the Rifts were, you know, the Rifts are fun. I'm not gonna lie. Those are...
I wanted to stay in the beginning zone and said screw the rest of the game.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, yeah, we got up to, like, level 30 or some shit, and then there's, like, no one in any of the zones, so it's like, we can't do these Rifts anymore. You know, so it's like...
I'll go back and play with the other people.
Yeah, kind of loses its fun when that happens, quite honestly.
Now, Warhammer Fantasy, I liked traveling in that game.
Yeah, yeah, that game was good.
Too bad AE killed it.
AE?
EA. EA. EA Entertainment.
Electronic Arts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They killed it.
Yep, they really did run that into the ground. But that's a lesson on how not to fucking put together an MMO. Or I should say, how not to fucking...
take over one.
Yeah, it really was.
Oh, let's make it like this, and let's put this in here, and let's completely kill the whole mechanic of the game.
Yeah. What they did was they took a game that was designed for a niche market and then... tried to make it a WoW killer. And you're never... you know, WoW is gonna die on its own, and that's kind of the way MMOs are. They have a certain...
they have a niche market, and eventually...
they have a certain lifespan. I mean, you know, that's something too. People are gonna get tired of that shit after a while. It's kind of like wrestling. I mean, you know, you like a character, fine, wonderful, that's great. But eventually, you're just gonna get tired of it. You're just tired of seeing it. You're just tired of doing it, because it's the same damn thing. You know, and that's the way MMOs really are. I mean, yeah.
You got Daok, which is still around today.
Yeah, yeah.
But that's a very niche market.
It very much is. I mean, the people who play for it, they're not, you know, they've stopped making expansions for it, you know, as far as I know, unless they decide to do so again. They're not going to make any more expansions for it. As far as they're concerned, that game is done. It's not getting any funding in that sort of way. You
but
know,
they still let the players play it.
Yeah, yeah.
They still have the servers
still
up.
And they still have people there, you know, maintaining it and stuff like that. But as far as, you know, expanding and, you know, continuing...
oh, and also, like, with the original Star Wars game.
Oh, Galaxies?
Yeah.
Yeah, Galaxies was a game that was before its time. Really, it was.
The thing is it's only survived because of the players' love for it.
Well, I mean, that game was actually actually closed, like Warhammer was. Like, shut down.
Yeah, completely. Then the players are like, yeah, we want it back. And then so they've been going back and rewriting all of the programming for it.
Yes. Yeah. So, I mean, that's... I don't expect that to ever fucking, you know, come back or anything like that. I mean, it's...
no, but the thing is, it's a niche market. People enjoy it.
And like
it
I said,
has
it was
a lot of...
it was a game before its time. It gave... It really was. I mean, it had so many options. And really, it's the way a Star Wars game should be, not the way that the fucking new one is. The new one was made for those fucking MMO junkies who just log on to PvP and be a Jedi. That's really what that game is for.
But I want to be an interior decorator.
Yeah, yeah, like I said, in Galaxies was a game that was like, look, this is we're not creating a game. We're creating a
world.
Yeah, we're creating a fucking universe here.
You wanted somebody to make you a fish tank? There's somebody there
you
to
want
make
someone,
you a fish tank.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you want someone who's... you need a fucking doctor. This guy over here, this character. This character is a fucking doctor. He's a player. He's a fucking doctor. You know, he'll fucking...
you got the musician.
You got people who are fucking musicians and
that just
people who had real jobs and, you know, did real things and real roles within
if
the
you
game.
Didn't wanna, yeah, if you didn't want to be combat-oriented,
you didn't
have to be combat-oriented.
Exactly, you know, and there... it was basically... what they did is they didn't create, you know, like I said, a game. They created a society. That was the idea. And like I said, it was way before its time, unfortunately. And that's really what led to its downfall is it came out when WoW first came out. And, you know, like I said, it was so different and so in-depth that people were like, well, I just want to play WoW because it's simple and, I'm scared, you know.
Scared.
Yeah, really, that's what it is. And now today, you know, like I said, now the WoW market is refined to a point where the players who play it are all these hardcore junkies who want to do this one thing and only one thing in the game and, you know, want it their fucking way.
I like the older trees better.
Yeah, yeah, and that's the thing. They wanted it streamlined, you know, and then like I said, they got things in there to prevent dumb players from playing in game. Well, you know, and then of course, like I said, they get pissed off that people aren't playing in game.
Too simple. Yeah, when you make exactly. It too simple. You make it
too simple. I mean, you know, it's an MMO. You're gonna have to deal with other people in the game and other people not being quote unquote as fuck room. Yeah, I did. I always do this. I always think she's in this one for some dumb reason. But yeah, people just think that that game is just, you know.
I passed on.
Well, like I said, and people take games too seriously nowadays, you know, and it's a job now. Oh, I don't want to fucking pay, you know, pay to have another job. Why should I pay to have another job? No, I want to play a game that I'm going to enjoy. And if, you know, working my ass off for ever to get anything in a game, you know, isn't fun to me. That's not enjoyable. But that's just me.
I finally got into the cave.
Oh, that's fine.
Just hang on.
Not a big deal. At all.
I think you actually have to do the quest to get the rep for these guys. Oh, well.
It might not unlock until you get to a certain point in the storyline.
True.
Because I know when we do the quest here after this, the enemies and shit drop stuff. Like, every faction, you know, has stuff that enemies beads. Drop shit for. Yeah, beads or whatever that you can just use and get rep with them.
Oh.
Yeah, now you gotta accept that. There you go. Alright. Ready? Let's travel.
Woohoo! Big giant gate.
Yep. And we get the keys to Karn Doom. I believe this is where you get the shit for whatever now, you call it. Like, they actually go into the dungeon and shit.
Must pass the gates of the Iron Fortress and free the Ranger from the clutches of Mordor.
Tread carefully now. She's a fanny pack.
Be careful. Try not to
pull too many.
Yeah, cool. We have to keep her alive, and I believe when I did this solo, she ended up dying a couple times. It's kind of frustrating. Because, yeah, you end up fucking tagging four mobs. It's like, fuck!
I'm DPS.
Yes, I don't heal your ass, bitch! So, like I said, if just kind of let her pull things, I guess, is what I'm saying. Let her take care of that. Handle them as they come, so make sure her dumb ass. Look at that. I mean, she's taking 2,000 damage already.
Yeah, I can't heal her.
And I don't think, if I remember right, she just kind of just keeps going and going and going. Doesn't seem like I can switch to tank here, too.
If she lets me.
You gotta go quick.
I'm trying, but I'm stuck.
Oh. I'm pretty sure there's a part in here where she'll give you a chance to rest.
Yeah.
And then if you're gonna do that, you gotta go quick. Because I'm tanking stuff over here. So is she.
Stuck.
Anyway.
Switched.
Better come over here and help her. She's taking damage. I've already pissed one off. I thought I was on her, so. Yay for dual specs.
Switched it right in combat too.
What?
Switched in combat too.
I don't think you were in combat. Your weapons weren't drawn. That's what being in combat is in this game. Your weapons are drawn. She's fucking taking me already.
Yeah, I'm healing her.
There you are, there she goes. Bitch. Don't like her. Like I said, this instance, if I remember right, was pretty tough because she just keeps going and going. And got especially solo. And they're right when they say that, oh, the challenge will be great if you're soloing, because it is a bitch. And then you get these little fuckheads that just spawn. She's looking for her dad. She's like, are you my daddy? Oh, yeah, now he has some anger and warriors. Yeah, fuck. Yeah. high, high priestess that's like standing inside people and spotting. Yeah, this is pain in the ass. If I remember right, this is about how many of these guys spawn in the solo list.
Well, the great thing about it is when you switch specs, it remembers what button to
press. Yes, it does. Yeah.
I'm like, yay! I don't have to try to figure that out. Why are you trying to keep it?
Yes, yes. They do a pretty good job, like I said, in this game of that.
I'm keeping her alive, plus me. I'm also healing her.
Yeah. Oh, with your AoE shit?
No, I actually have two heals.
Yeah, fuck.
I do like the tank. This tank, though.
Yeah, two big ass trolls. Yeah, this is the shit that irritates me. Like, you get done with that, and she just takes the fuck off. She is just
really
gone.
She really wants her daddy.
Like, I mean, I don't mind. Like I said, I like this. Because you do some pretty good shit in here, but it's just like, god damn.
I am knocked the shit out.
Yeah, these are fucking monsters. Fucking warm shit over there. Fucking shaking the screen. Imagine being a fucking caster like I was. Shit. What's going on?
Well, I am glad I did go into tank mode.
Yeah, like I said, imagine her fucking tanking this shit. You got a DPS and a little bitch. It's not fun. It's
definitely
not
since
fun.
They redid the Runekeeper. Because you used to be able to heal good and do DPS. No, now they actually only get to do one or the other.
Yeah. Well, actually, that was back then. That was back. Did I do that before? I don't remember. I think I did it back then. I think that was one before. Man, now I got these little. I do like how they're like little evil hobbits though.
They're so awkward.
Yeah, I know.
Big,
very
bulbous
awkward.
Heads.
Yeah, they're like little chibi heads. Like most goblins have. It's one thing I like about Lord of the Rings and the art that they've come up with for Lord of the Rings. The goblins don't have chibi heads. They're just little short orcs basically.
They look like fish.
Yes, they look like fish. They look like
don't
fish.
Don't we have to go that way?
Hold, I will open this gate. Alright, bitch! Strange key don't work here, goddamn. Is there another gate? Yeah, where all these motherfucking trolls are? Oh yeah, we gotta go punch a hole through this bitch. Alright, let's go. Go time. Now it's just us. Careful, because you got like six dudes over there. So angry. I do like them, though. Jesus. Can you use yourself, or should I? My bees go, my minions. Sting them in the ass.
I still think it's a very good tank. Just saying. That can be me. I like that.
Oh, you mean the bear as a tank? Yeah, I think the bear as a tank is pretty good.
Well, you're an AoE tank.
A little bit.
You're not single target.
It's a smart tank. It's not a spam tank. I'll give it that. You gotta kind of, like, manage your shit right. Hold on, I got these guys. I'll give him some bees.
I can give you crabs.
I give you crabs. What do you want, lobster?
So now since I've been so used to doing DPS, it's like really, I'm like, oh look, I got so much wrath. What am I doing? And then I'm like, oh, that's it now. That's why.
Yeah. I don't know what to do now that I can actually do things. Oh.
Yeah, thank you for disarming me.
Impossible. Starry shit. Alright, now we're good. I can hit you with my beating stick. I cannot wait to get legendaries in this guy. I am still thinking about giving up on him though, but.
Or can at least I not be stunned this long? Holy shit.
Yeah, well, it was first me and now you, so deal with it.
Alright. Baron.
Yeah, bear times. Bear times for your faces. Yeah, interrupted your ass. Bitch, even though I think you deflected my attack, which is weird. I don't know how that worked if you deflected it. Unless you interrupted him.
I just kill things.
We are getting rep for these guys, so maybe we are now getting rep for our... Yep, there we are. Council of the North. Yes. Hey, bitch. Bees. What? You deflected my bees? How do you deflect bees?
Because they're awesome.
How do you deflect bees, you bitch?
How dare you? How dare you? Those are my bees. My goddamn bees. You have bees. There's more bees for you. I like the bees. Bees are fun.
Did you forget?
Yeah, I forget a lot. Like I said, this class, I have to definitely say, is for the advanced player, I think.
It's not an easy class.
Well, it's not for the lazy player. I think it's one of those
you're
ones.
Lazy.
Yeah, absolutely.
You're the lazy player.
Yep, I am. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a lazy player. That's why I don't play in-game WoW shit. I don't wanna fucking... I don't wanna work for it. Fuck that. I want a game that is fun and easy to play. Which WoW is easy to play up until you get to the raid shit and it's like, we're gonna make it hard because we're gonna make sure you're good for the other players. I don't wanna fucking be good. I just wanna
kill things.
Yeah, I just wanna kill
them. I get a little bit. I get happy.
Yeah, you do a little bit more so than me. I mean, I get
frustrated. Yeah, I get mad. You do.
And for me, it's like, I guess I've lowered my standards. I think that's what it is. You have higher standards because you've played with people who are competent at WoW. Whereas me, I've played enough with fucking other people. And, you know, I mean, I've been in a raiding guild, and I know how that shit works, and I know how those people are. And I said I lower my standards for some of the damn people. What irritates me more are the people who do bitch, I think is what I'm saying. Those people who control, especially in a pickup group.
Them, I just yell at my computer.
I know, yeah, I know. And you do sound like those people who bitch at them in the groups,
yeah,
the dungeons.
But at least I'm nice enough and I don't actually tell it to them in their face.
This is true. This is absolutely true.
But, hello, High Priestess.
Like I said, for me, it's just I just gave up. And that's something too, like, you know, hey, I can level without them, you know? If it pisses me off, I'll just go do something
I like kicking them out of the dungeon.
Yeah, I know you do. See, that's the thing, I mean, I've played enough of those dungeons, but they're not that interesting to me. So I'm not missing out on anything if I'm not in there. I just don't care. It's like, alright, I'm not in a fucking dungeon because these people are stupid and don't know how to either tank or heal or whatever, you know? Not a big deal to me. I'll just do something else to level. Because there's plenty of other shit to do. I can handle, you know, not being in there. You are more addicted to the dungeons, though.
I love dungeons.
Yeah, you like them way more than I do. Like I said, I've done them enough, and I've done them so many times. It's like, I don't... Yeah, it's a dungeon.
Well, that was like one of my favorite things was the open PvP in Warhammer.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
I was so addicted.
Yeah, that shit was badass.
You're like, hello, and I'm sitting there like so engrossed that I'm apparently a zombie.
That shit was badass. That's what, like I said, that's the niche market that they were looking for. You know, and yes, they were fun, but like I said, once they put the BGs in the game, killed it. Because people are like, we want BGs, because they have BGs in WoW, and this game sucks compared to WoW, and I want BGs because it's quicker.
This game sucks compared to WoW.
And then, well, yeah, that's exactly, like I said, that's exactly, you gotta turn the lever here, dummy. You want
there's a lever?
It. Yeah. Flip the switch. Now she's like, good work, now you can try and protect my dumbass.
Silently now. Darkness approaches.
What are you doing?
I'm just standing.
Oh, okay.
I was I'm
what are you
I'm
fighting? Are you fighting something? So I was like, should I not click on it yet and kill that first? Before she decides to run past everything and then aggro more shit? Like I said.
Do you see these guys have 50 feet?
Yes, and that's awesome, isn't it?
But you're knocked out again.
Swinging that shit. I love you. This is Like, it's just the rate at which they attack. They're not slow, it's just, they're all just swinging shit. Oops, I'm going to cut my...
You're bare now.
Heal, so, fuck it.
Oh,
yeah, froze this one. Oh, nope,
pulling
for
them.
Yes, just go into the other one. I'll attack them. Good times in Warhammer when they had the open PvP shit.
Oh shit, I forgot she had stopped by here.
Yeah, and you just went running. Gotta pay attention. Gotta pay attention. My sword is not my faja.
Good.
Yeah, right? Isn't that good? But anyhow.
Tree, come out.
That is something that, you know, I've always tried to get you to play a dwarf in any game, but you refuse to do it after you loved the Ironbreaker in Warhammer 2.
Yep, since then I don't want to play any other dwarf.
Yeah, I know, like it just ruined dwarves for you for like the rest of your life. It's fucking lame. It really is. It's really good game. You can use that dwarf, you can use a fucking hobbit! Fucking hobbit!
I'll find one eventually again. There's gonna be enough MMOs coming out, that'll be fine.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like there's not.
At least you MMOs play those damn cat monkey people in Final Fantasy that I like.
I have pepper ears.
At least you play them, which I do like them. I think they're pretty cool.
Oh my god, people are dancing.
Yep, they're dancing. They're summoning shit, man. Intruders! The Deverdins, the Hillmen. I'm getting some meat sticking me in the ass and some shit.
He likes it.
He likes it. I don't like it. Fuck him. I don't care what he likes. I don't like it.
Everybody pushing.
Yeah, I do. We just went bare mode and like, I'm a girl.
I do like how I get to stand her a lot more in this farm. That's one reason why I like this.
Well, actually, like I said last night, they do a great job of making tanky and damage and heals all feel very different. You know what I mean?
My favorite healer in this one is actually the Rune Healer.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'm just saying, they make all of the specializations, you know, heals, tank, all your standard shit, all feel, and even the support, they all feel very unique. They all feel different. They all feel, you know, you don't play the DPS one and feel like you're a support guy. You don't feel, you know, you don't be the tank and feel like you're DPS. You know what I mean? You don't play, yeah, it's just the way it is. Oh, no, not that one. They're going over.
She was casting something.
No, now there's like three guys over here in the giant. Right, well, oh, now he's just gonna kill all of you. Fuck you all!
He looks bad. Just saying.
Huge, too. Now, fight their ankles. Fight their ankles. That's one thing I do miss about, like, the rock, all the fucking giants and shit. Good times.
I like the Minotaurs.
Yeah, the Minotaurs. Maybe that's a game we'll go do an LP at some point. Yeah.
I don't even know. I need to make a new town.
Oh, you'll probably get it back. I got mine back pretty easy. It's not that hard. I was surprised how, because I couldn't remember what my shit was. And then like I said, went and talked to them, and they were really easy about getting it back. And it was pretty quick, too. It didn't take me long, so.
Wow would never give me mine.
Oh, I know. Wow is so fucking... There's such a stickler about
eventually
shit.
Eventually, I just gave up and made a new account. Fuck it.
Yeah. Well, fuck, I had no idea what my shit was before we, you know...
We can't... It was during...
Yeah, it was years ago. Fucking years ago. God. It really was. Oh, fuck, Lordy. Took a hard left.
She didn't want to walk through the green stuff.
Man, I don't know why we're walking around the whole damn thing when you could have just went this way to fucking get where we're going.
Just gotta follow her.
He is not here, clearly.
Stay alert.
That is the case. Come now, Khandoum lies before us.
Big giant gate.
I know, yeah. They do a really cool job. That's once again the thing I like about this game, where WoW loses itself, is they make everything big. The gate to get into Orgrimmar is this big. Oh, fuck me in the ass.
Hey, look, there's her daddy.
Yeah. Flop. Oh, I'm fucking dead, man.
I love this armor.
Mordorous?
Yes.
Yes, they do such a cool job with the fucking...
It's just like, you can tell, you're evil.
Yes. Yeah, Mordorath has some cool shit. I'm not gonna lie.
I have my red armor that makes me look really evil, but it's meant more for a caster.
You have those big shoulders that look like the Zelda Pain, don't you?
Yeah, that's, but yeah, it's still very caster to me.
Oh, there goes Lorneal. Lorneal's dead. Yes, it is very caster.
Where'd she go?
Fuck her ass up. I don't know where she went.
See her body, that's the
There's
problem.
A treasure cache. I'm gonna open it.
Carol, just you can take this.
Oh, minimum level 90. Fuck you. You're not fun. Fine, alright, I'll just come over. Kick my ass. Everything like that. Holy shit. Hey, bees! Go bees! Jesus Christ. I know we're not obviously gonna kill them. Slowly, yet surely.
Deflect.
Yeah, I know, right? Jesus.
This is why you oh, should shit. Be the correct level for instances.
Yeah, they do a good job, though, of, like, these with these guys, where they're not gonna kill you. It's just there for a good guy. Fuck! Don't hurt me! I'm a nice guy! Just
play with the bear, over here.
Yeah, play with the bear. Play with the bear, he's your friend. Mommy bought you him for Christmas. You'll tie the rope and fucking pull it. No one knows what it is.
Are you sure?
She's trying to be funny. Jesus. Always so serious. Punch it. Drop my club. Blah blah blah. I'm awesome.
Damn. Am I healing?
Oh.
He's like, fuck you.
No,
you take 1/4 of my life. I say, oh, big angry eyeball.
Eyeball of death.
Leave me be.
And there you go.
Where did her body go?
She went fucking flying, man. She just goes somewhere.
I fear we have not seen that.
So, part. We have. Huh?
Lorneal, daughter of Golodir, sought to free her father from the clutches of Mordorith at Carn Dûm. But her plan was folly, for Mordorith slew her at the gates and allowed Golodir to go free, a broken man. What hope can Eriador have against a wraith nearly the equal of the Witch King himself?
So there you have it.
She dead.
She dead.
Even though she's like on our screen, she fucking just got punted.
Yeah, she like, yeah, got punted. That was pretty badass, I'm not gonna lie. She's gonna fly. She's like, bye bye, have a good time.
Hmm.
What?
That's better for you.
Lots of things are better for me. I think I'll take that over the earring. I really will. Now we have the gates of Carn Dûm.
So now we can do the dungeon anytime we want. Yay.
Could I speak with you a moment?
Mm-hmm. Put onto your key ring.
Yeah.
I remember that for WoW.
What?
The key ring. So you can get
it. Oh, on
the,
WoW?
Yeah. Remember, yeah. You had to have a key. At least somebody in your party had to have the key. To get
yeah.
It.
Yep. Yeah. Yeah. Hmm. So, oh, what the hell? Oh, yeah, I got that. I guess I'll equip that, I guess. Oh no, where'd you go? Badass hat. Alright, there we go. Alrighty then. So, Galadriel's kind of pissed at us.
Because we killed his daughter.
Yeah, apparently we fucking killed his daughter. Fucking dickhead. Anyhow, so, next time we will go ahead and talk to Laerdan and get shit rolling. That is going to be, if I remember right, a 3-part quest that Laerdan will give us, and depending on how fast they go, it may be like one episode per part.
Per part?
Yes, because we have to, alright, we have to go over here to Barad Gularan.
Okay.
And go into the towers. Now, this place is crawling with fucking monsters. So we'll have to go down here and fight our way into something and then do, like, a little event in a boss fight, basically. Kind of cool shit. Well, at least for 2 of them, I think. Maybe all 3. Oh, I don't think so, though, because I think we have to go dig a sword up or some stupid shit like that. But anyway, that's what we gotta do. And like I said, I may or may not be able, I think it's going to take a while because we're going to have to fight our way there. And obviously, with us being underleveled, it's going to be quite the adventure and kind of dangerous. And I think that's kind of fun. But that's just me. Anyhow.
Yeah, definitely with my cockiness.
Well, yeah. Yeah, that's what you want to call it. Anyhow, all right. That does it for this episode. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye.
Bye.